Om Namah Shivaya. Hi friends, how are you? In this video, we are going to learn about features of Aird's paralysis and Klumke's paralysis. Before going to the topic, please do subscribe to my channel. Watch this video. If you like my explanation, please subscribe. Coming to the topic, features of Aird's paralysis and Klumke's paralysis. And the nerve roots involved in Aird's paralysis, C5 and C6. And the nerve roots involved in Klumke's paralysis, C8 and T1. And the muscles paralyzed in Aird's paralysis are deltoid, supraspinatus, infraspinatus, biceps brachii, brachialis, coracoradialis, supinator, extensor carpi radialis longus. And the nerves paralyzed in Klumke's paralysis, all intrinsic muscles of hand. Next, the position of the upper limb or hand in Aird's paralysis. The position of upper limb in Aird's paralysis and the position of upper limb in Aird's paralysis is policeman's tip hand, porter's tip hand and waiter's tip position. Okay, this is in Aird's paralysis. When it comes to the Klumke's paralysis, claw hand. And the sensory loss in a paralysis, along the outer aspect of the arm or along the lateral aspect of the arm. This is in Aird paralysis. When it comes to the Klumke's paralysis, sensitive loss along the middle border of the forearm and the hand. Sensitive loss in Klumke's paralysis along the middle border of the forearm and hand. And the autonomic signs in Aird paralysis absent. Autonomic signs in Aird paralysis absent. And the autonomic signs in Klumke's paralysis present, that is Horner syndrome. Autonomic signs that present in Klumke's paralysis, that is Horner syndrome. See these figures. This figure shows the Aird paralysis. Why the Aird paralysis causes? Injury of the upper brachial fluxes leads to the Aird paralysis. An excessive increase in angle between the head and the shoulder. If you observe here, this person falls on the shoulder, and this makes the increase in angle between the head and the shoulder. Okay, this is pushed like this. Normally it is like this. But when he falls on the shoulder, it makes the excessive angle between the head and the shoulder. Okay, and this causes the injury of the upper brachial plexus and causes the Aird paralysis. See this figure. In this figure, here traction of arm and the traction of arm, extension of the neck causes the injury to the upper brachial plexus, also causes the Aird paralysis. This type of hand you observe in the Aird paralysis, we call this policeman tip hand, porter's tip hand, a waiter's tip hand. Okay, this type of upper limb position you observe in Aird paralysis. Okay, in Aird paralysis, we call this position as policeman tip hand, porter's tip hand, and the waiter's tip hand. Okay, see this figure. And these positions cause the, if you observe here, and this position cause the injury of the lower brachial plexus. Okay guys, this type of positions cause the injury to the lower brachial plexus, which leads to the Klumke's paralysis. which leads to the Klumpke's paralysis. Injury to the lower brachial plexus causes during the excessive increase in angle between the this is the trunk and this is the upper limb. Okay, excessive increase in angle between the trunk and the upper limb. If you observe here, the angle is increased between the trunk and the upper limb, causes the injury to the lower brachial plexus and leads to the Klumpke's paralysis. And the first example is hanging. Okay, hanging with the support of one hand leads to the injury of the lower brachial plexus and causes Klumpke's. Maybe hang on a tree either with the rod help. Okay, and the second example is pulling of the hand. Pulling of the hand during the delivery also causes the increase in angle between the trunk and the upper limb. This also causes the injury to the lower brachial plexus and causes the Klumpke's paralysis. This is about the features of a paralysis and Klumpke's paralysis. I think it is clear to you. Reply me on comment section, guys. Is it useful to you or not? If you like my explanation, please like, share, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.